one day I think I was reading an article or I saw a news report about a job that had become obsolete.
He was talking with his friend about, you know, would the what they were doing, sitting there penciling, inking, you know, drawing, would that also become obsolete? And he said, you know, I just feel like, I don't know, like the Last Mortician or something.
And I thought, well, what about death? What if, you know, suddenly, you know, death stopped and people just were living perpetually? I had been kicking around this idea in my head, that just that thesis, you know, but I didn't know how to write it. And so I tapped Tim and I was like, Tim, I have an idea. I called him up one day and I said, you know, I have this idea called The Last Mortician, but I don't know what it's about. Can you think of something? I was playing around with different ideas for what this character would look like. So I finally arrived with what this character looked like, and I kind of like this guy because he looked near death.
I mean, I sort of, you know, felt like the first role as a writer is kind of world building, you know, like,
sure.
Oh, you know, put it in the context, and you start thinking about what are just the parameters, what makes sense, what's logical, what's not, and then, you know, you have to, that's where some of the casting off comes
and that's
out.
What
could
I was
it be this,
on.
Could it be that?
I was counting on Tim doing that because, you know, I do a certain kind of world building, but I knew, or my instinct was that this was going to be political, religious, social commentary.
I came up with these different character designs, you know, starting with this, getting to that, and then transitioning to here. And then, with the script, I started laying out the story. Because I draw it small, the reason why I draw it so small, if you see my hand, it's, you know, it is like a thumbnail sketch, because I want this to have story clarity this small. Once I draw it bigger, this is just the execution and the craft. But this is the hardest part of the whole process for me, not only as an artist in collaboration, but as a writer as well. Because no matter what I try to convey in my typing, in my writing, or my initial thoughts and putting it together, it all happens here. This is when it becomes comics. You know, I struggled for a long time with trying to become a penciler for Marvel Comics.
I could have gone down and worked at the stock market. I probably could have gone out to Hollywood and worked as a gopher or other things.
I was like trying to figure out, well, all right, maybe I'm not good enough to draw Iron Man or Batman or something at the time, but you know, I have something to bring to the table. I like stories, I tell good stories, and I can do that in this medium.
Actually, this is our first major collaboration together in over 15 years of knowing each other. It's taken us this long to actually finally come together and work on something.
I learned a long time ago, being different is important. You know, really say something that's not being said. Write and draw something that you want to read and see.
I'm a romantic with a small R and with a capital R, and that's kind of where the story took me. So it wasn't so much a meditation on death, but love within a context of deathlessness.